for the gift of life and for the strength that we are enjoying today. We praise you and we worship you for giving us this opportunity to study together once again and to learn how we will use technology for the furtherance of your work to win soul for you, dear Lord, in preparation for the short return. And so today, dear Lord, we'd like to pray for guidance. May the same Spirit guide the writers of the Bible, guide us today so that we can be able to learn important principles and concepts so that the tips that Serwin will share to us will help us to maximize our capability in sharing the good news to the people around us and even to those people who are away from us. And so today, dear Lord, we are hoping that you will make this class meaningful. And we pray in a very special way for Serwin as he extends and share his time, valuable time for us to learn. So may you guide him, dear Lord, hide him in your glory so that your righteousness will be revealed today. Somehow, as we listen to him, we'll be able to conceptualize things that will make us effective instrument of yours in sharing the gospel through technology. And we pray for each one of us, dear Lord, and even for our loved ones away from us, and for students who are involved in this class as they continue their ministry there in the field. We are hoping, dear Lord, that you will bless each of the effort that they are doing somehow as we close this inter-semester. So our effort will become successful because you are the one who guide us and you are the one who convert people to the Holy Spirit. Thank you, Father, for hearing us and lead us in our class today. In Jesus' name, amen. Okay, good morning to everyone. Like what I had said in my announcement, we are happy and we're glad that Serwin accepted this opportunity. Yes, we understand that he's also busy, but we just lended his time and we are happy that he favored us in this special request. So I hope that all of you answered the survey that we posted in our platform, because it's very important for Serwin to understand and to know what your interests are. And so we will just know from him as probably before we end our class today if we will have another meeting tomorrow. In fact, Pastor Amoral told us that probably he will have another seminar probably next school year about these things. And I even suggested that if we can include this course in our curriculum, I think this is very important because we are now living in the time of technology, and that is very important for us to understand concepts and tips and secrets and methods how to maximize and use our technology in evangelism. And so we are happy today that Serwin is with us. So, Serwin, we welcome you in our class, and we are so thankful that you lended your time for us in this class for us to learn. So, we will now give you the time, and we will just wait for your announcement if we will have another meeting tomorrow. I think you have now an idea about the result of the survey, so you can just probably relate it to us, and you will just decide if you're still willing, and though you are also busy, but if you're still willing to spend time with us tomorrow, so we will give you another time to share some important concept. So good morning, sir, and welcome. So we are now giving you the time. So most of the members of the class are now in the meeting.
Hello, good morning, Court. Just checking if you can hear me properly.
Yes,
yes sir. Loud and clear.
Okay, good morning. It is I would like to thank Pastor Kadao for this great privilege to help the evangelists, the pastors to be in media ministry. So it is really my love to help in the work. In fact, I think I'm going to finish all my money in doing this, in helping the pastors and the evangelists and the laymen and everybody who wants to preach, because I personally think this is the best thing to do in life. So, and I'm very honored to be part of your ano your your efforts to help in figuring out what to do. So let me try to share screen so that we can see the results of the survey. Okay. And I think 4 people have answered already. Let me try to zoom this in so that. So these are the topics that I usually give in the media ministry seminar. And I think the most popular is the how to stream and record. Okay, for this class, because there are so many topics that we can discuss, but what I want to discuss is the ones that you are interested in. So we will prioritize the topics that have the highest score, like this streaming, and then this score with 3, and then the ones with 2, and then the ones with 1, and okay, so let me just paano na ba ito? This one. So I have been helping just a little bit of history. I have been helping with media ministry, and I was trying to figure out why I like to spend a lot of energy and resources in media ministry. And then I found a quotation from Ellen White. I heard in from one preacher. They said that he or she said that are there foreigners here?
Actually, okay. Sir, meron tayong isang from US, but yeah, but he understand Tagalog, sir.
Okay.
Yeah.
Because yun daw pong nakapalapit sa'yo kay Christ is the thing you also want to use to bring other people to Jesus Christ. So then I realized I was benefiting a lot from video ministry, audio and video ministry from Audioverse, from GYC, and I was downloading so many sermons. I think all of their sermons I downloaded, thousands of sermons, and then I was giving away to other people the downloads. And and then I realized, my faith was strengthened in media ministry. That's why I want to help media ministry. And so, and then the Lord, since I want to help media ministry, the Lord gave me many friends in media ministry. So the people in Hope Channel, the people in HCBN, I help them and then they help me. And then it's very nice until yung mga nakikita natin, mga tao na preacher sa TV. The Lord is giving me opportunity to drive them around, to help them, etc. So it's really very nice, aside from helping in the Voice of Youth and so on. This is a ministry that is like the written publishing ministry. I remember when Ellen White was already becoming old, God said, the Lord told her not to spend all of her time in doing preaching and going for event for speaking engagements, but to spend more time writing. Because then the wisdom of that is that now we have so much too much to read, but if she did not spend time writing, she spent time preaching and speaking engagement and so on. Those people, it's not documented. There were no cameras at that time. So now you can see the 3 books behind Pastor Kadao, the 3 blue books full of counsel, so much nice counsel that we can benefit. So in Habakkuk 2, I think 22 or 2:2, I'm not sure, it says that the Lord showed Habakkuk a vision and then write it down, make it plain. But now, so the vision, the live streaming is from heaven, according to Habakkuk. And the Lord said, this is the vision, you write it down, that he who reads might run. So it might, the word of God came through vision to the prophet, and God told Habakkuk to write it down so that people who read may become energized. So it's this media ministry is the Word of God really gives energy, and we can use this whether it's vision or it's written to spread the Word of God. So when Ellen G. White died, her writings are still working. She's gone already. She's sleeping. But her writings, whatever she recorded, if there were cameras before, then it's still going. So if you record your sermons will work even while you are sleeping, even if you pass away already. I remember in one of our media ministry seminars organized by NPUC, when he was not yet ordained, sir, sino yung AWR po? Si pastor na siya ngayon sa AWR ng NPUC. I forgot his name.
Cernerio?
Apo, si Cernerio.
Cernerio? Yes.
First time yata niya magsalita. Sabi niya, naiiyak daw siya because he was just, I think he also took theology, but he was just the audio man ng Pastor Larry Fair. Pastor Larry Fair is my relative. And then Pastor Larry Fair recorded so many Tagalog sermons, and they were transmitting it, AWR was transmitting it all over the world in shortwave radio. And then somebody came, and then of course Pastor Larry Fair died because he was old, he retired, and then he died. After 2 years of his death, somebody came to NTUC. He said, "You know what? I became an Adventist listening from sermons of Pastor Fair in the ship using shortwave radio. I want to meet Pastor Fair." And then Pastor Fair already passed away 2 years ago, and his sermons are still evangelizing all over the world. So this is the nice thing, your recordings, if you put them in Facebook, if you put them in YouTube or whatever other platform that comes out, it will do a lot of work. In fact, one of my friends, if you know Kuya Jun Lumingkit, he used to be a tricycle driver here in Puting Kahoy, the bald man. He was a theology student also of MVC, but he did not finish because he got married. He was helping in evangelism, and he found a nice lady here in Puting Kahoy. And he got married, but he still likes to preach. And the fact he's one of the preachers that are around here in the community. And one time I met him. By the way, the most important thing, I want to thank Pastor Kadao for spending much time in prayer. The most important thing in media ministry is prayer, not the equipment, not the technical know-how. Because when I observe, whenever I pray to God what to do, sometimes we wake up in the morning, there's nothing to do, especially on Sabbath morning. The Lord gives us ideas, and then the ideas, when we try to do them, when it's from God, it becomes very nice. I mean, it's successful. It's not so hard. Sometimes it's hard, but it's very fulfilling to ask God for an assignment, and then God will give an idea, and then you can do it. So it's fun. It's more fun in ministry, as they said. So in my experience, I just help and then meet people. That God helped me meet Kuya Johnson. I was also cameraman in Ted Wilson, sometimes in Dog Watcher. Those are my friends in Hope Channel. If there's an event, I just go there, I show myself, they will assign to me a camera. I just hang around. Oh, Sirwin, you hold that camera, because Hope Channel has more cameras than people. So whenever they see somebody who is there, I'm there, they will assign me one camera, and I'm very happy to use it. So it's a very nice experience. In Ted Wilson's time, we slept about 2 weeks in PICC. Yeah. So this example, like Kuya Jun Lumingkit, I want to mention this because I want to encourage you to record your sermons. I met Kuya Jun sa baba. So may Carmel yata yun, dyan sa baba. So he was preaching because I like to drive people. So I was driving some students going there. And then Kuya Jun also came with his tricycle. And he preached in the hour of worship, Pastor. Kuya Jun preached. And then he was preaching with all his heart. There are only a few of us in the sala of one house there. I think they are trying to start up church. And then, alas 12 na, it was already 12 o'clock. And he just abruptly cut his sermon. I observed that he did not finish his sermon because sermon has usually landing or nice conclusion. He just cut it because it was 12 already. And then I said, Kuya Jun, if you want to, I know you did not finish your sermon. If you want to finish your sermon in record, you can come to my apartment and we will record. I will record you. And then he was already dreaming, praying to have a media ministry to record his sermons kasi bumili siya ng, he bought a camera, but he doesn't know how to make the audio clear. Sabi ko, I know how to make the audio clear, but I don't know. I want to preach, but I don't know how to preach, but I know how to use a camera and a microphone. And then he came, so we recorded, I think now here we recorded like 70 to 80 sermons. I look at my YouTube channel, I think I typed Jun Lumingkit, some 70 or 80 sermons come out. And then I said, Kujun, you know what? How many Bible studies can you do in one day? Because he was a layman of Pastor Gulfan or other people. He said, I think 5 is a lot already. I said, you know what? One of your sermons has 900 views a month. So you divide that by 30 days. Your sermon is giving Bible study more than what you can do in physical face-to-face. And that's all around the world. And then I showed him the map. You look at this map in YouTube, you can see the map. Which country is viewing the most? There are viewers in Afghanistan, in Iraq, in even in war countries, Pastor. There are viewers of our channel. I said, Vicky, don't have money or visa to go there, but it's all around the world. So many people are benefiting. The most numbers of viewers are in Philippines because his sermons are Tagalog. The second is the U.S. I think there are many Filipinos who are in the U.S. And the third is Saudi Arabia. In Saudi Arabia, my auntie cannot even bring her Bible openly because it's not a Christian. They are not very friendly to Christian faith. So even if our channel is not successful in Philippines, even if it's not for the U.S. people because it's an open Christian country, but even just for the people in Saudi Arabia, I think our media ministry is worth it because there are so many people there and so many people come from Saudi Arabia. They come home and then they contact Kuya Jun and then they want to baptize. They just show up in Putengkawi Church. And then the deacons there and the elders, they say, oh, there are people who are walking around trying to look inside the church. You come in. I said, they say, I want to meet Brother Lumingkit because I just came from the airport from Saudi Arabia. And I want to be baptized. So this and then this Pastor Lagarile, and when he knows that he watched Kuya Jun's Lumingkit, he will just get the baptismal gown because he knows that if you watch Kuya Jun Lumingkit, it's very long. The sermon is very long. I said, Kuya Jun, there is no limit to how much you can preach in the studio. In TV, there is limit, maybe 30 minutes or 1 hour. But in my studio, there is no limit. You can preach until I fall asleep and then until I wake up again, you can still continue to preach because YouTube has no record limit. And it's like a book. You know, a book has no limit. Yeah, it's long. But you don't have to read from page one to the end in 30 minutes like you are preaching in PIC or in an evangelistic event that you have to cut within 1 hour. In YouTube, you can just continue like people are washing clothes or cleaning the house and they are listening to the sermon and then they can close the browser. When they open again, it will continue. It's like a book. So you can actually record everything you want. So that's Kuya Jun like that because he actually records, he preaches long. there are preachers who like to preach long. His average sermon is about 45 minutes. Sometimes it's 2 hours. So... And then I look at Mark Finley's, because Mark Finley had a Discoveries 08 series. And I download all the sermons because my download link dun sa discoveries08.org. I downloaded all of them. And I'm the first one in the whole internet to upload that series. I did not pirate it because they already give the download link. So anybody can download. And I uploaded it in my channel. Anybody can upload also. But I'm the one who first did it, and I have many views. And I look at all the series, the 28, 23, the 23 series, and I found out that the Mark of the Beast 666 topic has the most views. So I told Kuijun, Kuijun, you are finished with 10 commandments, you are finished with Sabbath, change of the Sabbath, salvation, etc. We recorded with just one camera and a microphone. That's why, and then a projector screen at the back, and we record like, I think, 10 sermons like that. The important thing if you want to buy a camera is that you buy a camera that has a microphone input, a microphone socket, because you want the microphone to be the nearest to your mouth, not something like it's you sound very far. You want it to be near so that the ratio of the noise around the chicken, the people play, the kids playing around, the electric fan. And so the ratio of noise and the voice is big, so the background noise becomes very small, and your intentional voice becomes very clear. So I let him use this mic like this, and I was recording only with one camera with a projector screen at the back. So, Uncle Kuijun, you know Kuijun, in Mark Finley's series, yeah, we know that there is a sequence. In the book Evangelism, you should not discuss the most, Ellen White says, you should not discuss the most objectionable parts of our beliefs first. You should keep them somewhere there in the middle or in the last, according to the book Evangelism. But if I look, but in the internet kasi, if I upload everything, anybody can find any topic. And if they are interested in that topic, then if that's a way to get their attention, then we can use, what can we do if it's already there? So people are not viewing number, people like to view number one because it's about Daniel 2, usually Daniel 2 prophecies about end times, etc. But there are so many people viewing the 666 Mark of the Beast, I think from curiosity or fear. Or so I said, Kuijun, you want to preach Mark Finley's series, the most views are in 666. Do you want to preach a sermon like that? He said, okay. After 2 weeks of researching, Kuijun is translating Mark Finley's sermons, Doug Bacilong sermons, Stephen Bohr sermons into Tagalog. So, tinatagalog lang niya yung kay Stephen Bohr na prophecy, at kay Mark Finley and Doug Bacilong and other favorite Adventist preachers in the U.S. So he did a series in Mark of the Beast, not series, a recording. And it took 2 hours and 20 minutes, Pastor. I think 2 hours and 40 minutes. Almost 3 hours. In fact, I fell asleep two times in the sermon. And we were using a switcher that time because I bought already a switcher. But some pastor in the U.S., I sent the switcher to his house, and he brought it here, Pastor Ivan Remocal. So the first switcher is from... It's also brought by a pastor. And I think much of my equipment, because in the Philippines, you buy it about 80,000. In the US, you buy it about 50,000 pesos. So, makatipid ka ng 20 or 15,000. So, I sent it to their house and he came. It was Kuya Ivan's, it was Ivan's father, who is also a pastor. I forgot, but most of my equipments I brought by other pastor friends from the U.S. It arrived in his house 1 hour before he left for the airport. So he was saying, I think the Lord will use this equipment. So we were switching. And then I realized that Kuya Jun 666, it's 2 hours and... you know, the average view of YouTube is 3 minutes. People are impatient all over the world. It was 3 minutes at that time. But our 666 and Mark of the Beast, the average views is more. I think 1 hour or 45 minutes. That means more people watch the video. So, and then I realized something very important that I want to show you so that you can also copy. Kuya John 666 Mark of the Beast has more views than Mark Finley's Mark of the Beast. So I was wondering, I was puzzled. How come I uploaded Mark Finley's Mark of the Beast a long, long time ago, like maybe several months ago, 3 months ago. And then I uploaded Kuya Jun. Now, if I look at the statistics in YouTube, Kuya June has more views than Mark Finley's sermon. So I was really puzzled. How come? And then I realized, Pastor, that there are many 666 Mark of the Beast sermons in English. Because anybody can upload. Doug Bachelor can upload. David Asheri can upload. All the pastors who speak English can do that and upload. And there are plenty of them. But in Tagalog, 666 Markanang Hayop, there is only one sermon in Tagalog about Markanang Hayop in the whole internet. I realized that when I type Markanang Hayop, only the upload from my channel came out. At that time, there was no other video about Markanang Hayop in the whole internet. So all the Tagalog people who like to type, the Holy Spirit impressed them what to type in YouTube, in Google, they type Markanang Hayop. Only our sermon comes out. That's why Kuya Jun's sermon has more views because he is the only one, he is the first one to upload. I'm the first one to upload a Tagalog sermon on the Mark of the Beast in the whole internet. And then, yung Mark Finley, yung English, everybody is distributed because there are so many English. But in Tagalog, we are the only one. So I said, when I observed that, I said, we have to do this also in all the languages that we can. Because English, yeah, Doug Bachelor is there, Mark Finley is there, all the English speakers are there. But in the dialects that we know, that they don't know, Mark Finley doesn't know Tagalog, doesn't know Bicol, doesn't know. Then it became my goal to put the Adventist message, evangelistic message preaching of all the Filipino languages just to help. So I try to encourage the people yung nasa harap ng NLAC, MPM. I try to encourage all of them. You preach in Bicol, you preach in Ilocano. I like the people in North Luzon Mission. They are preaching in Ilocano and also in Pangasinese. So they have two languages. So I like to help people who are preaching in local dialects, although the views are less because they are like there's a media ministry in Bicol. I lent them a video camera like this. And then I'm trying to lend them a computer, but I haven't found a nice computer. Nice cheap computer. I like to buy cheap equipment, Pastor, because there is no end to expensive equipment. There's no end to expensive equipment. But what I want to do is to lower the cost. So I try to find equipment to do research and find equipment that will lower the cost of media production. So there are many kinds of, of different levels. If you are just one pastor, one preacher with a webcam, what kind of webcam? If you want to have a real video camera or a DSLR or a mirrorless camera or a full-fledged video production. So, so my goal is to help you in your evangelism. If you want to preach in different kinds of dialects, it's very nice that Pastor invited me here so that you know me. And if you have a question later, or in ministry, you can ask me question usually I have many friends who are evangelists. If I listen to their audio, and then I am annoyed. How come it's distorted? I will contact them, and then I said, you fix this one. If they don't have money, I lend them equipment. So, did you hear class? I am lending equipment to evangelists. So, I think there is more money in this world than faithful stewards, because equipment doesn't get tired, but the preacher gets tired. These days, there are more studios than preachers. I mean, the studio can run 24 hours like a factory, but the preacher, it's very easy to turn on a camera and press record and press stream. That one is easy. You just buy equipment, and then it used to be that there are many preachers who want to have a camera. Now, there are many cameras not doing anything 90% of the time, but it is the preachers who have to, because it's not easy to preach. You have to pray about it and so on, connect all the verses according to Ellen White says. You have to know the connection of all the verses, and you have to pray. And the more you pray, the more impact the... By the way, one more thing, which I observed. I also like to preach. But my sermons, Pastor, has only few views. I also, when I saw Kuya Jin preaching 666 Mark of the Beast, I said, I will also preach. I got the Mark Finley's slides, and then I preach it also. But my sermon has only 10 views or 20 views. But Kuya Jun's sermon has 900 views a month. The same topic, almost the same slides, but Kuya Jun's is longer, and mine is maybe 1 hour or 45 minutes. How come Kuya Jun has more views? I think Kuya Jun, and I was trying to find a documentation, a reference for this. I found in the book, I think Gospel Workers, I'm not sure. Ellen White says, the Lord does not accept the the ministry of the preacher who is not doing visitation, something like that. So now I realize why my sermon has only 20 views, but Kuya Jun has 900, because he has been a layman. He spent, since he was college until now he is 50 years old, he has been doing lay work. And he has been visiting homes for a long, long time already. For decades, he has doing visiting homes. And me, I'm not visiting homes. Maybe I have only visited homes when I was in the Voice of Youth. But so the more, so now I observe, I'm just looking for people who are already good in evangelism. And if you help them, they will also be successful in the internet. And I'm trying to see why, how come? It's not just preaching and reading PowerPoint and making the graphics good. There is an element also of the Holy Spirit is, I don't know. I tried to research why, because I can preach also and read also and explain also. But Kuya Jun, he preaches, he reads, and many people get baptized. So I'm just comparing myself and trying to look for the reference. So if you are successful already in real evangelism, and you put yourself in the internet, you will be most of the time you will also be successful. There are many evangelists who are shy, who are shy to the camera. So we just have to help them. So those are my observations and the reasons, the benefits of media ministry. But now everybody is doing media ministry on Sabbath. The whole in Facebook, everybody is doing their live stream. So now let's go. Enough of the stories. I want to go directly to the topics. Okay, I told stories so that more people can answer the responses. The first topic here is streaming and recording. Yan. Maybe I will share screen so that you can see what I do.
Okay guys, you may open your camera at least para mas maganda kung open ang inyong camera. Okay. Ayan.
By the way, you can interrupt me with questions anytime. Because if you have a question, you just ask. Sometimes you can forget your question if you don't ask.
Your testimony, sir, is really an eye opener, sir. Your testimonies and the stories that you related is really an eye opener.
Yeah, praise the Lord, Pastor, because no, the Lord give us that allowed us to help others so that we can help others also. We can help more. So the software that we use is called OBS. It is free. It is used by gamers to transmit their game stream in the internet. But we are using this OBS. So you can download it for free if you have a Windows computer or Mac OS 10.13 and above, or Linux computer. And this is how it looks like. You have a screen, whatever. And you can compose your shots here. Like you can put your camera here, and you can put your PowerPoint here, something like that. So, okay, let me show you an example. Let me show you Bicol Wireless. Something like this. Yeah, like these people, they are or they have the old ones. For example, like this. So this they are using OBS. So you can put your graphics here. Yan, katulad yan. So you can put your webcam here like this, and you can put a picture here, and you can put your slides here. You can lay out your screen any way you want. You can put some logos, even you can put this scrolling text here, and you can record. You can click record and start stream and so on. So this is the most popular, even the people in SSD, Anthony Stenier, Sir Pastor Ron's assistant, they are using this. So it's free. The nice thing is it's free, and it functions like a video switcher. If you, a while ago that Pastor Remocal's family helped me bring an Atem. This is the switcher that PIC uses also. Something like this. This was before ito yung Luma. So the switcher was like this, and it cost, this is the cheapest switcher. The switcher Hope Channel uses is $3,500. The switcher, I'm mentioning the prices so you will appreciate the OBS, okay? The switcher HCBN uses is $6,000. And etc. So this is the cheapest switcher. It's only $995. That's almost $50,000. But when OBS came out, by the way, if you want to know what a switcher does, you can connect many cameras here, like in PIC, diba? You can connect many cameras here, and then you can see all of the camera angles. Like this, something like that, diba? In PIC, you have this, the program out, this is what comes out of the stream, and these are all the camera inputs. And then the PowerPoint is here, the lower thirds is here, and then some logo is here, and sometimes you also put the overlays and so on. So this is the job of a switcher. This is the switcher we have in PIC now. We replaced the old switcher, but it's still working. Some of the ports are dead already. So you see the expense. This switcher is also in the same price, $795, but it's the newer version. But when OBS came out, OBS can be a switcher. Look at this. It can be a switcher also, and it's free. Your computer becomes a switcher. I'm so excited about this because I am probably the person who has the most number of switchers, Pastor. By God's grace, I have switchers everywhere, and all of those switchers, the original cost is $1,000. I lent one to Kuya Johnson, I lent one to Bicol, I lent one to Nagaview. I have one here broken. So, but OBS, I'm so excited about OBS because it's free. Your computer becomes the switcher. You can have two webcams, you can connect a professional camera. So when we record with Pastor Javier in Sabbath afternoons, I just connect the camera outside in the sala, and I have a cable coming in here, two cables coming, one from the camera, one from his laptop, and then one going back to the TV so he can see his slides or whatever I'm recording. He can see the program out. We call it program out because that's the label of the switcher. Whatever you select, whatever input you select is called program out. So Pastor Javier sees the program out, and then his laptop goes into my computer, the camera also goes to my computer, and I'm using OBS. In fact, let me start it here to show you. That's why I'm so excited about this software, because it brings down the cost of video production. It brings down the cost of video production. Let me just rearrange my screen. And so I can switch the graphics. Of course, you all see it's black because I didn't set up the cables now. But if you I click graphics here, only the PowerPoint of Pastor Javier comes out. If I click, I can also show the multi view like this. And so I can just click, and if I have a touch screen monitor, I can just like touch the monitor. it will switch. So it, the OBS really changed the world. It makes everybody, every computer a recording studio. So it's very nice. You download this and it will help you a lot. Okay, the next, let's see the next, ano yung aking ano, browser. Let me see the next topic. So you can do so many things in OBS. If you want OBS tutorial, there are plenty in YouTube. So many things, OBS. Yan. But most of the tutorials are for gamers. Yan, for gamers. Not for switching, for multi-camera. So that's OBS, Open Broadcaster Studio. Now let's go to the next topic requested. It's 7:45. Pastor, we end at 8:30, right?
8:30, yes.
Okay. Next is what camera to get. Okay, this is very good. Wait lang, streaming and recording. Just additional, let me get something a little bit. The reason I did this seminar in my house instead of the office is I can just pull out anything and I show you something. So let me just stop screen sharing. Recording, I haven't taken recording. OBS can record. Now you will not appreciate recording unless you know the expense of recording, the price of recording. It used to be when I was helping Hope Channel, I found out that the recorder, you can have a their switcher is $3,500. The recorder is $200,000, Pastor. So the switcher and recorder are different, but OBS can do both.
Wow.
OBS can do both.
Wow.
All you have to do is buy a computer that is a little bit good, but the computer is less the cost of the switch of the real switcher. So yung recorder ng the recorder of Hope Channel, I think the name is Aja, I'm not sure, it's 200,000. I said maybe if it's 200,000 it doesn't fail, but I heard that sometimes it fails. I said if it fails, then that's just the cheap one. So I tried to find a cheap one and I found out about this one. This is called Samurai Blade record. It can record and it is also a scope. It can look at the video scope. So I will try to share what scope am I talking about. Where is my browser? No, not that scope. Something like this. In Hope Channel, the scope is only scope is 75,000 pesos. It's like a monitor that can show you the video scopes like this. Something like this. It will show you how much red, how much green, and how much blue are in the picture. And if you are doing the bars, it can show you if the colors are accurate from the camera and from the transmission and from the cables, etc. So Hope Channel's scope is 75,000. It cannot record. It cannot switch. The recorder is 200,000, and the switcher is 150,000. So OBS can do all of this. And then nung nakita ko to, when I found this, it's called as Samo Atomos. This one can record and show the scope. Ayan yung scope, oh, nandun sa side. It can show the scope. And I got it only for $525. So instead of buying a 200,000 plus a 75,000 record scope plus a 200,000 recorder, ito, ano lang to. So it is only about 25, 27,000 It can do recording, and it can do the scopes. So the nice thing here is technology is becoming cheaper and cheaper. What used to be very expensive is now within reach. And now I'm just waiting for OBS to show this scope. But I think the development of OBS, because it's free, there are so many people contributing to OBS that it is overtaking even the commercial software. And so 750 recording. So you can do recording in OBS. How? Very easy. Just click start recording. And then it's recording. It says it will show you how many seconds it's recording. It will show you how much percent of the CPU is being used, how many frames per second, etc. So you can choose your format here, what recording format you can choose here, and how many how much bit rate you can do. Yeah, the more bit rate, the bigger your file. So this one is 3,500,000 bits per second, kilobits per second. So I think that's enough in my experience. The cameras, the lowest is usually 6 or 7 Mbps. And this is about 1 gigabyte per hour recording, if you calculate that. So you can choose audio, the resolution, you can choose it. If you have a slow computer, the auto configuration here will choose a setting that your computer can do. So very nice, OBS. It can do streaming. For streaming, you can just click settings and stream output and choose like Facebook and then, Facebook. And you, what happened? You can choose Facebook and then you can just paste the stream key. Usually if you stream, Facebook will give you a key and then you put the stream key here and then you click OK. And then when you click start streaming, then you become live in Facebook. YouTube also is like the same. You get a key from YouTube and you paste it here in key. You choose YouTube. And you paste the key that YouTube gives you, and you click OK, and you click Start Streaming, and yeah, there's no key. You can also, there are many modules that you can also stream simultaneously in YouTube and in Facebook. And so what I advise for is that we record in We can, if you have a nice internet connection, you can live stream. If you don't have nice internet connection, you can just record and upload it overnight. Sometimes it takes me 3 days to upload when the internet of AUP is down and I try to borrow my brother's. I upload in my brother's internet in Morning View. Sometimes it takes 3 days to upload one sermon. So you just record and then you upload and then record and upload. Most of my channels, my YouTube channels content are just recorded. I don't really stream. But in PIC, we stream. We have live stream because PIC is using the internet connection of the school. So we have our boss, Sir General, gives us full access there. And he is the one also there streaming. Oh, somebody is raising a hand. Please speak up.
Sir?
Yes.
Tatanong ko lang po sana kung kahit yung cellphone pwedeng gamitin pang camera.
Yes. Yes. Pang camera na pang stream o pang record ng
I mean, di ba po sa OBS po?
Yeah. Pwede you can connect your cellphone to OBS. There are many ways of doing it. I think at least there are 3 ways I know. The one is you can use open camera and you can make your cell phone like a webcam and then you can connect your OBS to the IP address of your cell phone and so that it will not a webcam an IP camera. You can connect the IP address, you can tell there is an IP camera and then OBS will show it. There are a few other ways to do it, like stream. I don't remember exactly, but I can send it. I can send the. You know what? I don't know everything, but since I am helping many other people, they tell me what's working for them. So I can just ask the people in Naga View what they use, because they have tried a few. The people in Naga Church also. So there are about 3 or 4 ways to do it. Some of them are free, some of them have payment, but I think there's basically your cell phone, you find an app where it converts your cell phone camera into a network stream, and then you open that network stream as a source in OBS. Yes, you can use it, but there can be lag kasi ano, it's your cell phone is converting it to stream. So it takes time, and it's transmitting it through Wi-Fi, and that you don't know how much traffic there is in your church at Sabbath for Wi-Fi. In the mountain, in Naga View, they're in the mountain. There's not so much Wi-Fi, but in PIC, Wi-Fi doesn't work very much in PIC because there are so many people there with Bluetooth on and with Wi-Fi on, etc. So it depends on your location. So the safest is really to use a cable, but I think cell phone is a nice, very portable. It can fit in your pocket. It doesn't cost a lot. You can use it for other things. And when you can walk around like this, it's not like a big camera that you walk around. You can walk around. And the camera now of the cell phone is very, very clear. In fact, in Naga View, I lent a few cameras there. But when they use their iPhone, which is only 27,000, it's the picture of the iPhone is better than the picture of my cameras. Because my cameras are 15 years old already. They are bought them secondhand. So it's very, very possible. You just have to you have to understand that there will be latency, lag. May lag siya. Because of the transmission and the Wi-Fi and the conversion, etc.
Parang mayroon pang question. How about you, Giselle?
Yes. Anybody Giselle, else question?
Diba sir, I was just suggesting po yung something they can use. For social media po.
Yes.
Yung app po na they can use for camera. Yung phone for the meeting at camera.
Okay. You try to... Android, are you using Android or iPhone?
Android po, Android.
Ito yata. Yeah, you download this one, and then in OBS, I just make a new test, and then I connect network. Okay, since we don't know, we can just Google how to add IP camera in OBS. And we can just, is there anything that I can just read? Media source, and then put your IP address of the camera. I cannot demo it because, so basically you have to add a media source though. No, I don't think it's media source. I think it's, ang na-try ko VLC source, and you put the IP address and ano. Sorry, I'm not very familiar with this because I use wire. And but if you can, I can send I will send a tutorial later. Okay?
Okay po, sir. Fact, thank you.
But you know, we don't know everything, but we can always Google how to use Android phone as camera for OBS. Okay, so you can just Google this, watch it, and then tell me if it works. But they are using NDI here. NDI is very new. In fact, they are just clamoring about the release, but it has payment. You need to pay. Ito pala yung ginagamit nung ano, nung Naga, OBS Ninja. But you have to be online. The problem here is this one is you have to be online because you have to, OBS Ninja is a website. So you have to have internet connection. I like IP webcam because even if I don't have internet, I can just, as long as I've installed IP webcam and I install OBS and VLC, it can work even if my connection is not reliable. But in OBS Ninja, come again. You were saying something? Or it was just okay. So yung OBS Ninja, you have to, it's simple to use, but you have to be online. Yung IP webcam, you have to know IP addresses and ports and so on, but you can use it even if you're offline. So there are many ways of doing it. And people will always come out with new ways of doing it. I think the most recent and the most real time is the NDI. But I think at the moment it costs some money to install the NDI transmitter in the phone. Yan. Pero if you want it to be simple, you just do the live stream in your phone and then you can. The problem with that is the audio, because diba, in your church, yung phone ganyan kalayo. So the audio sometimes is echoey, diba? So usually that's the first time because everybody has a cell phone. And then the next thing you can do is make the audio clear. If you have no other way of doing it, you try to pull one of the loudspeakers and point it to your cell phone so that it will get a very clear audio from the sound system. Or you can position yourself so that you are near the loudspeaker, but far from the electric fan. Kasi yung electric fan usually is the one that is being heard. And you tell the people around the cell phone, don't be noisy. But if you want real clear audio, you have to find a cable. Where is my cable here? You have to find a cable like this. Yan. It's called, okay, we will go to Lazada. It's called a TRRS extension cable. What is the TRRS? T means for tip, ring, sleeve. Oh. Diba yung sa ano, sa headphone, tatlo lang, tip, ring, sleeve. If you only say TRS, it's yan. Dalawa tatlo lang yan, diba? Tip, ring, sleeve. That there are only three. If you say TRRS, this is for the cell phone, there are four. So this is the ground, this is the microphone, this is the left, and this is the right. So you try to find a TRRS cable in, ayan, no? 154 peso. And then you try so that you can connect your cell phone and you can connect your, yung ganto nyo. Ano tawag dito? Your headset. You can connect your headset and put it near the loudspeaker. So you can have a nice frame and nice audio. But the problem you might encounter with this is there will be hum. Gumaganon. So that will happen maybe if you are plugging in your cell phone in the 220. So it might get signal. Lalo, if you try to put this wire beside a power line, then you might get hum because it is not shielded. Then you will go to the topic of shielding and balance cable. That's why in professional audio, we have the XLR connector. Yung sa microphone, ganyan, di ba? It has three connectors so that even if it will make it resistant to hum and to noise if you put it together with an extension cord and near an electric fan and so on. Because it uses a balanced audio transmission. I just want to explain this because it's very good for pastors to understand this. The reason there are three wires in the microphone cable, this is a ground, X, XLR, di ba? XLR is yung microphone ganto. Yung ganto, di ba? Do you see me? Do you see me?
Yes, sir.
Yung ganto po na kable. The one in the microphone. Yung number one, there are numbers there. Let's okay. Everything is in Google. Yan. XLR. So X is ground. L, number two, XLR. This is how I memorize it. Pin one is X, ground. Pin two is live or positive. Pin three is, actually it's not negative because this is not, this is not DC, it's AC. So the reason that why we use XLR in professional, kasi itong sa earphone, itong sa webcam, sa cellphone, it's not balanced. This is the benefit of using balance. If you have a long cable, you have to use balance so that it will not be noisy. If you only use two wires and there is noise, you cannot remove the noise. But if you use three wires and you have balanced transmission, when we say balance, one signal is the inverse of the original signal. So while the signal goes up, this one goes down. So baliktad, binaliktad niya lang yung signal. And when noise comes in, it will interrupt both the correct signal and the inverse signal. But if when it reaches the other side, yung baliktad na signal, it will be baliktad again and the noise will cancel itself. So the noise cancels itself. Parang ganto. Yan, ganto. This is a better explanation. This is the original signal. This is the inverse inverted signal. When a noise comes, like the washing machine or electric fan or whatever noise, it will interrupt both the original and both the and also the reversed signal. But when you combine the reverse signal and the original signal, you will see that the original signal is the noise canceled itself, di ba? Kasi yung pataas doon, pag binaliktad mo dito, pababa na. So pataas plus pababa equals original, di ba?
Mm.
So here, if this is negative 3 and the noise made it negative 2, dito naman, if it's positive 3 and the noise made it positive 5, when you plus negative 2 plus positive 5, it becomes original 3. O, di ba? So the noise will cancel itself. That's why when you see a microphone, you understand why there are three pins. Sometimes there is noise. Why? Because one cable is not connected or one cable is not working properly. So that's the possible. So another solution is to use wireless. Oh, I will show you what wireless to use. It's called ito, MX5. I haven't tried this, but this is the cheapest I found. You can use this in a real big camera, and you can also use it in a cell phone. But it's almost as expensive as half the cell phone, right? But the Bible says that faith comes by hearing. So, alin ang mas mahalaga? Yung picture, yung video, or yung tunog? Faith cometh by hearing. So that's why it's very important to, of course, in Habakkuk 2, it says that we should make it plain. That's why dapat malinaw yung projector, malinaw yung audio. But Romans 10 says, faith cometh by hearing. That's why we have to make our audio understandable. Even if not, it's not the best, as long as you understand the every word that is being preached, because that's the that's the basis, Romans 10. Kaya if you need to experiment with I buy a lot of equipment, pastor, just for experiment, so that I can tell the pastors and the lay people, this is what I tried, this is the result, and so on and so on. So I have plenty of equipment for experiment, because just to lower the cost of everybody I'm helping. So when they ask, I can tell them this is the currently the cheapest. Because yung katulad sa PAC na mic, nako, yung mic pa lang $500 na. Yung ganyan pa lang. Yung transmitter, $500 din. So, naubos na yung pera natin dun lang sa mic. But now, ngayon po, it's cheaper na because there are things like this that, that are cheaper. You can just connect it with your cell phone like this. You can also connect it with DSLR camera or something. Any other question? Let's go back to our survey. Streaming recording. Oh, ito na kaya tayo sa next. 8:10 na. We have 20 more minutes. What camera to get? Okay, I already put the price there, the answer there, so that I will not forget. If you're just one person preaching, the camera that you want to get is also the most convenient camera, this webcam. You can use your laptop camera, webcam, but usually it's low quality. The most common webcam that YouTubers use is the Logitech C920. This is the most common, the most popular YouTubers camera. Before they get money to buy a bigger camera, they use this Logitech. Oh, 6,000 peso. But I think, ito, 3.5. I don't think this is real. Sometimes they put price and it's out of stock. But the last one I bought is this one, 3.5, which I lent to the Bicol, the people who are preaching in Bicol, because I don't like their camera. So I have many friends. I don't like your mic. I will lend you a mic. So I don't like your picture. I will lend you a camera. And it is a great opportunity to help, actually. So if you need a camera or a mic, you try to send me a sample and I will try to see what we can do.
Anong pangalan, sir, ng camera? Anong pangalan ng camera na yan?
Ito po ay Logitech C920 or C920.
Logitech.
Opo, Logitech. This is the camera I'm using now. I don't know if it's clear, but this is the old, this is the, ito po yung ginagawa. This is very, very strong. Ito yung pinapang picture namin sa ICTS, katulad nito. So, naka-on, I think for the last 8 years, it has been always on in our office just to take pictures of the ID. And it's still working. It's very durable. Yung itong sa akin, laging nahuhulog ito po. Kasi sometimes I want to transfer it to the laptop. Sometimes, and it has, I'm sorry, I cannot show you. But if you look in the, maybe in the picture. If you look in the picture, you can see that you can connect it on top of the monitor. You can, sa ilalim yan, meron yan tornilyohan. You can connect it to a tripod. In fact, it comes with a tripod. And this is the box. Yeah. So you can get the 922 or the 920 or the 920E. I think it was a 920E. It's still the same thing. You know, 3.5 na lang. It used to be 5,000 in PC Express. And then I got this one for 4,000. But the price is going down. Now you can get it for 3.5. And it has, it comes with this box. Ganito yung box na nakuha ko sa Shopee. And delivery, it can be delivered anywhere almost. Next, ano pa yung next na question? What? Oh, so that is for the one camera. If you want two cameras, like one zoom in, one close. Usually, if you're alone, you just want one camera. But if you have a switcher, somebody to assist you, to give you multiple angles, somebody who is just clicking in OBS, wide shot, close up shot. When you're doing appeal, close up. When you're explaining with your hand, wide shot. When you're showing the PowerPoint, then full PowerPoint, etc. Or depending sa OBS, what kind of things. So if you, for convenience, you use a webcam. I have a webcam like this. If you want quality, sandali lang po, I'll get something. Yan. I told you convenience ang webcam because if you want to have quality, then you start to carry things like this. This is my current recommended camera. Do you see me or do I need to... Nakikita niyo ako kahit na naka-open yung ano ko, share?
Or, okay lang, sir. Medyo maliit nga lang.
Okay lang, sir. Okay.
Maybe I will... Okay. So I it's okay. I will just... So this is the current camera, mirrorless camera I'm recommending because it doesn't overheat. It's called the Panasonic GX, Panasonic G7. Ganyan siya. Yan. Low bat na kasi, naubos na. So, maybe I will stop sharing so you can see.
So, mga how much, sir? Mga worth, how much?
Oh, good question. Nandyan lang yan sa Lazada. It's called a Panasonic...
G7.
DMC G7. Yan po ang price. Yan. So sa Lazada, sa ganito lang. It's cheap. By the way, we were trying this in PIC a few Sabbaths ago because in PIC, this is the cheapest 4K camera that doesn't overheat. Oh, that's my advertisement because I really like. For many years, I have been researching. I have so many cameras, my friends. I have so many big cameras all around there in the Philippines. I lent it to many people, but I'm always looking for, it costs 30,000, some of them cost 75,000. And I lent them to people who like to do ministry. But I try to research more because I want to increase the quality, but lessen the cost. And I try to research what 4K camera is the cheapest that doesn't overheat. Because if you're just recording weddings or documentations, or testimonies, you only need to record 5 minutes and so on. You can buy a Sony camera. Very expensive, but very good quality. But it cannot record your long sermon. It will overheat. Because the sensor is big, even if it's dark, it's bright. But since it's big, it generates heat. And since your camera is small, where will the heat go? It will overheat. It doesn't. That's why the big 4K cameras are big, like this one. It's big. It can record for hours and hours and hours continuously. But when I bring it to PIC, parang nababali yung likod ko, Pastor. Kasi ang laki-laki.
So nga, ano? So, bigat shadow. Bigat.
Magandang bumili. Kaya lang, yung mga wala pa nito, nangangarap silang, they are dreaming of buying 180,000 camera. But if you have this already, it's very heavy to bring.
So pag stationary, pero pag dadalhin mo talagang very ano, bulky na,
yes,
bigat pa.
Yung kaibigan ko sa ABS-CBN, siya yung taga-talaga, siya yung cameraman, may tagadala pa ng iba na tripod. So tatlo sila, isang driver, isang cameraman, isang tagadala ng tripod. Tapos yung reporter pa. Tapos yung ilaw pa. But if pag tinatamad ako, ito na lang webcam. Or if I want to increase the price, the quality, I use this. So this is the price of...
this is Panasonic.
Yes,
that's the Panasonic,
by the way, I like Panasonic because I have many friends who are Sony, but broken na. Yung sa IS, broken. Yung sa HCBN, broken. But yung Panasonic ng Hope Channel, we don't like to use it because it's old, but it's still working. So I try to recommend the Panasonic. There are many features for Sony, but reliability. I have also Sony big cameras. I have two big Sony cameras, but I have more Panasonic cameras than Sony cameras because they last longer in my observation of other ministries and in my observation of... So ito po, you can buy a cheaper one that is also 4K. It's called GX85. GX85. It's cheaper. Oh, saan yun? Ito, 24,000 with lens. But if you Google overheating, if you leave it recording under the sun, it can overheat. But itong G7, I have never found overheating in the internet of G7. Mm. Po. Pero ang problema nito ay you have to set it up, you have to bring this, and you have to connect it. If you need to connect it with your computer, you have to get something like this. You have to get an HDMI cable, and you have to have like this, a capture device. If you want to capture 4K, this one costs 6,000. If you want to capture only 720, 300 peso lang. 300 peso lang yung ganto na pang 720. In fact, Lipad, ano, not Lipad. Banahaw View Academy, I'm speaking fast because I have only 1 minute. Banahaw View Academy uses the cheap captures and uses the old Nikon cameras which they hacked so that it will not time out and shut down. And they have 3 Nikon cameras and they have 3 or 4 cheap Chinese 300 peso capture. And they look, it looks nice. And they only transmit at 720. So there are many ways to do it very cheap. There are also ways to do it high quality with correct colors. The problem with the 300 peso capture, the colors are not correct.
Yes, sir. Yeah, I know that Lukban.
Yeah, if you look at Lukban, you can see the picture, you can understand the message, but the colors are not correct. You look at the white, it's not white. You look at the green, it's different. You look at Manila Center, I'm not sure if they are still using the wrong converters. It's not correct. So there are, this is the cheapest one that's correct colors, but it's 6,000 peso. Just the capture.
Ang thousand yan, sir?
This is, ano po, ano nang brand nito?
Yung
it's called Camlink. Elgato Camlink 4K, yeah.
Camlink.
Okay, let me share. So that we can see. Yan. 6,000 peso sa Lazada and so on. This is the cheapest, currently cheapest accurate color rendering we can find. But, so this is the one I use with Pastor Javian's camera on Sabbath afternoon. But for his PowerPoint, I just use whatever HDMI capture I have, which can be only 300 peso. There are so many cheap HDMI capture. Yeah, it something like this, 249 peso, it's okay. As long as nababasa yung black and white na text, it's okay, yeah. But I can also buy another Camlink, but I think this is okay. Nobody ano, knows that I'm using a 249 capture. Ito lang gamit ko po. So, if you buy a Camlink, you spend 6,000 peso. If you buy this HDMI capture, you only spend 240. So if you run your calculator, how many, oh, if you buy the cheap one, in 6,000 peso, you can help 24 media ministries. So it's nice to have options. That's why I'm showing you the options, depending on what you want to do. Is the video 24 times better? No. It's not even 2 times better. It's, I think, 80%, 20% better only. So, di ba? You try to calculate also how much you want to spend. Okay, it's 8:22. Nako, I think, Pastor, what will we do?
Okay, sir. Since you still have more topic to share, I think. Are you still willing, sir, to spend time with us tomorrow?
Yes, I'm very. There is no other better thing to do than to help the evangelist. I'm just wondering if they are still interested tomorrow or.
So can we hear your response? I think, sir, yeah, most of them are interested. Yeah, look at the reaction
of
our students.
We are interested so much.
Okay. Yes. Let us help each other. Po. Thank you.
Let's make it final. So we will have another meeting tomorrow with Sir Win so that the rest of the topic that you are really interested will be shared. So I hope that you will again attend our class tomorrow on time, 7 to at least to 8:30. So more reaction, guys, before I mentioned some important announcement. Wala nang reaction. So it's final. We will have another meeting tomorrow. Okay. So that Sherwin can still share the rest of the topic that most of you are really interested. And so, sir, meron pa tayong meeting tomorrow, but As of now, we would like to thank you for, yes, it's really overwhelming. Huh? Maraming mga bagay akong na-realize at na-reflection today. Huh? So I think the student have the same feelings about these things after hearing those things that you have shared with us. Nagkaroon ako ng maraming interest tuloy. Sabi ko, naku, ang dami pa ng mga opportunities.
Yes, Pastor, kaya I try to record you as much as possible whenever I am with you, di ba?
ngayon ko na rin. Totoo nga, sir, kasi kahit yung Saturday sermon, after the sermon, nakikita mo yung views. After another week, you can see that still the views are increasing. That's why we can easily conclude that after preaching, your sermon still preached while you are doing something and you are kumbaga unknown to you, but your sermon is still kumbaga reach the hearing and the heart of people.
Yes, but for the amount of time you spend to prepare and the amount of effect it will have on other people, it's the best really po to be recorded. Kasi you prepare po, di ba? And then you preach. If it's not recorded, then they will just forget. But if it's recorded, sometimes I watch my own sermon and then I tinatamaan din ako.
Oo nga, sir. Nagkaroon din ako, sir, ng interest na yung kung makakabili pa na nung camera. At least pag na-invite ka ng Saturday, pwede kang mag-set up para i-record yung sermon. Then after that, pag uwi mo sa bahay, kahit wala sigurong internet dun sa church na pinuntahan mo, kung meron kang recorder, may camera, you can upload that after, kumbaga, when you go home, na meron kang internet sa bahay. And that's the reason why I became interested after hearing those things and then the options, buying camera and then the other things related to that so that you can have a complete set na pwede kang mag-recording. Kasi yes, yan ay yung talagang trend natin ngayon. And I hope that the student had the same feelings about it. Someday, if you are there working in the district, you can, at least you can probably buy and secure these things, complete set for sermon recording. And then when you go home in the night, so Sunday, while you are doing your stuff and your chores, you can just let the computer, kumbaga, sabihin natin, ma-record and then ma-upload it. Na kumbaga ma-record, sa pag-record na na-upload mo, at least ay dituloy-tuloy yung ano. Yes, I noticed that the sermons of Brother Lumingkit really patronized by people. Huh? There are so many views. I even noticed that how this men are really kumbaga effective yung kanya mga sermons na naka-upload sa online.
Yes.
And I learned today that somebody was behind that, and that is Erwin.
Yes, Pastor. There is something very funny. Kuya Jun's English is not very good. Kuya Jun's Tagalog is not very good. Even his Bisaya, he forgot already his Bisaya. But it's amazing how God is using even broken English, broken Tagalog. I don't know, but the Holy Spirit is using many people.
Yes, yes. Okay, thank you so much, Erwin. And guys, so since it's now 7:30, we will allow Sir Win to leave the meeting because I think this is another thing. So far, sir, thank you so much for the spending and sharing your time with us today. Yeah, we learned a lot, and tomorrow we'll have another meeting with you.
Thank you, po. See you tomorrow, po. Thank you, po. Bye-bye.
Okay, so thank you so much. Guys, before we dismiss and let's pray first before I mention and I relate sa announcement. Let's pray. Loving Father in Heaven, we thank you so much for your kindness and your goodness today. Thank you for the wonderful things that we have learned and heard from an expert in relation to using Niji Ministry and maximizing this technology for the gospel to be shared. Oh Lord, we pray in a very special way for Sir Win, and we continually use him while he is using his resources for the benefits of your work. Lord, this exchange, this dedication, your blessings in so many ways for his life. And bless each one of us since these lectures and tips and points serve as an eye-opener. Help us, Lord, that in our modern times, we'll be able to use this for the furtherance of your works. Be with us today in Jesus' name. Amen. Well, before we dismiss, guys,